The biggest change is around foreign exchange fees. Previously, customers could spend up to $6,000 a month and avoid racking up any foreign exchange fees on most currencies. This limit is now decreasing to just $1,000 a month, which, even though according to Revolut most people won't hit, is still a big reduction. Above this limit, the fee will stay the same at just 0.5%, and Revolut will let you know if an exchange will be subject to a fee. Premium and metal cardholders still have unlimited exchange, as they always have. The markup on exchange rates at weekends is also increasing. Currently, Revolut customers avail of the interbank exchange rate on weekdays with a 0.5% markup added to currencies at weekends. This is now increasing to 1%. This is still likely to be a much better rate than you get with your bank, but the gap at weekends will close. If you make a transfer to an account outside of your country, only your first payment each month will now be free. After that, there will be a fee of 0.50 per payment. However, payments to other Revolut users, transfers in euros to accounts in Ireland, and transfers in euros within the single euro payments area are remaining free. But if you want to send sterling to the UK, or dollars to America for example, you'll be charged 50 cents going forward after your first transaction. Finally, if you make a transfer to a country that is not in its national currency, there will be a fee of 3 for US dollar transfers, like US dollars being sent to the UK, or 5 for non-US dollar transfers, like sending sterling to Brazil. Revolut is saying it will always let customers know if a transaction they are about to make will incur a fee. When are the changes coming in? These changes will take effect on August 12, 2020.